After the financial collapse of 2008, I decided to make a change in my life and actually prepare for the possibility that there could be a systematic collapse here in America. So with that said, I didn't know what was coming. I still don't know for sure what's going to happen, but I've been preparing, and this is what I did. I started to store food. I started to store water. Then I started to store some more food. Then I started to store some more water. I made sure I had water purification tablets. I made sure I had water filters. I also made sure I had a means of protecting whatever I had by getting firearms, whether it be my Mossberg 500, my Glock 21, my Mossberg ATR 30-06 bolt action rifle, my GP Wasser 1063 AK. Then I made sure I had a 22 from Marlin. Then I got another AK, just for fun. I also made sure I had some ammunition, and I need to get some more ammunition. I also made sure I had an emergency bag in case I had to leave my house for whatever reason. Along with that, I also made sure I had the first aid. I made sure I had, I even built my own first aid kits, for crying out loud. So that was actually pretty fun. I also made sure I had some tools, tools that didn't require electricity or anything like that. And I essentially acquired the things I thought I would need in case there was a big emergency. Now this includes oil lamps, flashlights, batteries, and lighters. Books, games, toys, anything that can keep your kids entertained. Whether it be an economic collapse, a personal crisis, or a natural disaster, you're gonna wanna be prepared for the next crisis. So I've been preparing for the last 3.5 years, and I have to say that I don't regret it for one second. I'm happy with my progress. I make mistakes, but hey, I learn from my mistakes. And I just wanna encourage you guys to be proactive in preparing, whether it be getting a concealed carry permit so you can carry a firearm to protect yourself at all times, or whether it be just storing food and water. Hopefully you can have some type of weapon to actually protect yourself in case things really do get out of hand. But in any event, you know, I just want to encourage people to think about what will they do if a crisis happens. Make some common sense steps to prepare now so you won't suffer later. I don't care if you have to start off with rubbing alcohol and hydrogen peroxide for cuts and wounds. Hey, make sure you have a fire extinguisher in your house to deal with fires. There may not be a fire department in a very extreme situation. Who knows what's going to happen, but in any event, thank you guys for listening. Thank you for watching. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.